everybody. I'm Cinnamon Cooney, your art Sherpa, and you and me today, we're going to finger paint. We're going to paint with our fingers, and we're going to do it live. On the mic today is my husband, John.
Hi, guys.
So that's the voice that you hear in the background. He controls the camera, so you can really see all of the splattering finger painting action that we're going to be up to. This is going to be very expressive. This is going to be very messy. I'm going to have some really great safety tips for you to make this fun and, you know, aware, and also some, like, let go and have some fun success tips. So you guys are really going to love this. Definitely, trigger warning, it is messy, though. So maybe not in a white living room.
Yeah, yes, definitely not on white carpet.
Really, I shouldn't even be doing it here. I have my messy shirt, and I even put my hair up in braids. And before we start, acrylic paint is cleaned up with rubbing alcohol. You okay, babe?
Oh, yeah, just fine.
Okay. Don't breathe the tea.
Yeah, no, I was just about to say, don't breathe the tea.
So we're on a 9x12 canvas board here. I like canvas board for finger painting because then you're not stretching out the drum when you're pressing into it, which as a new artist you might be doing. And, you know, even though this is finger painting and you might be doing it with little brushes, realize that there's a whole genre of art for this that is quite serious. And I have some more information about who you might check out in the links below if you're like, this is my jam and I want to know more, and maybe in the iCard too.
Yeah.
All right, so here we go. Here's our 9x12 canvas. All right. I have some wishes on here because we always like to put some wishes on here. Pam Bethel was wishing for some relief from fibromyalgia. Mm-hmm. We had a bunch of wishes come in for mental well-being. Maddie, who's a little brush, she's healing. She's got some tummy stuff going on, and they really need to figure out what's going on with her. Mm-hmm. Also, there's some wish coming out from my big art quest to single moms and single caregivers that are out there. It is really hard to be a caregiver and be working and try to find time for yourself. And if you're feeling overwhelmed by that, know you're not alone. There's not somebody out there who's like handling it smoothly. It's just hard all the way around. And so this is definitely dedicated to you and LGBTQ acceptance around the world, where we can just be loving and tolerant of each other.
Those are all good.
I like those. So let's look at the materials today.
Okay.
So pre-gessoed, ready to go canvas board. Super important material.
Wipes. clean up.
You're going to love this, okay? I have some plastic cups over here. In this plastic cup, I put titanium white, and I'm going to show you how to thin your paint for the splatter. I've got a mixture started here so I can show you how to mix it. In this plastic cup, I have a mix of phthalo green and cad yellow, just a titch of phthalo green and a lot of cad yellow, and I've thinned it with water, so that gives you the idea of the consistency. And this mixture is phthalo green and phthalo blue. We call that actually a phthalo turquoise. On the palette, in heavy-bodied paint, which makes this super fun, I have quinacridone magenta, dioxazine purple, titanium white. This one's important. We're going to switch this to cad yellow medium hue. Because we're going to be splattering. We don't want this really on our skin or in our eyes or anything. Also, Hansa yellow, any bright lemon yellow for this project will work. You just don't want to use cobalt or leaded paints or cadmiums when you're finger painting. Even if you're doing gloves, I think unless you're professional, there's no cause for it. The naphthol red, phthalo green, and phthalo blue. And of course, I have some tea.
Tea.
Which I will cover as I'm splattering. And safety goggles.
Safety goggles.
Because we can get so messy.
Yes. Well, there's a whole, everyone's out here. They're very excited. We have a full crew. There's your gloves. You got
thanks
some gloves.
Thanks to, this is, we got these from our local Harbor Freight.
Yep.
It's not a sponsor video. It's just where we get cheap gloves. I got small ones. Try to get gloves that fit your hands well. It will help your little brushes, or if you're small-handed. I have some very good friends that are lovely adult brushes, but they have teeny tiny little hands. So success-wise, you're going to want a tight fit to that. The reason I don't recommend in general going full skin to real acrylic paints is that there's anti-foaming agents. Even though they say no known side effects, they're saying there's none we know about right now. So sometimes on stuff like this, you're like, why find out that you're the one?
Right. And we have these things called gloves, which are cheap and abundant. And we can just use them.
You haven't ruined your manicure. Take off your good jewelry.
It makes for a faster cleanup, too.
Take off your good jewelry.
Yeah, definitely.
Stuff you care about deeply. So I've got my gloves on, and I'm going to pull my fingers down.
And
Oh,
go ahead.
Oh, okay. And I'm going to come over here now using my palette knife. You could use a brush or my palette knife. I'm going to make a little mixture to the side here. Mm-hmm. I'm going to take one part green mm-hmm. and one part blue, and I'm going to make some phthalo turquoise. You can buy this in a tube. You could use Southern Ocean Blue, mm-hmm. right? But this is just a nice way to do. And when I'm mixing, I'm going to be using my palette knife. You could use a brush, though.
Yeah.
You could use all kinds of tools. You're just trying to make a mixture. And I'm going to start out by getting a little bit on my fingers and getting right into my white.
Oh, yeah.
And I'm going to come here, and I'm going to just put it on my canvas.
Just get some on there.
And enjoy myself. Right? Ooh, just spreading it out. It's fun. A little bit. I am going more white. Right? And you can see I could have probably even gone a size down in the gloves. But, you know, sometimes the men's tool store does not have
They did not
tiny
have
tiny little gloves.
They did not. They were out of smalls. So I was.
Or apparently they had them, but
maybe they didn't. Maybe this is the smallest one they have. Because I don't think that there was an S package. I think M.
Yeah, you might need to be like maybe in the medical profession or something to really have access to that.
Yeah, we'll have to go.
But you know, these were really economical for this pack of 100.
Oh yeah.
I'm putting a little more of this wonderful color on my fingers with the white. You can absolutely use student paints for this. The fun of using professional paints is, believe it or not, this is a whole fine art movement.
Oh, yeah.
And there are some tremendous artists working in it. I like this because I'm getting in here and I'm just blending. It's all still true. All the art I do is still true.
So you're leaving a lot of it just be kind of blendy on the canvas.
Right, yeah. And I'm smoothing it out, but I, you know, there's your fingers are in it. There's some reality of some expressive brush strokes.
Some finger strokes.
There's finger strokes.
You're literally.
This is definitely a workout on your day.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
It's like you could even just say your
Now I've got to make up some more of this, but maybe I'll just take my little finger over and mix it right here.
Oh yeah.
And not even use my palette knife. Look at me go.
You're just spreading it in there.
Right? Ooh, that's fun stuff. I'm going to get my fingers a little damp.
You just pick up some water?
These are just my brushes, right? Look at that. There, that's going. So I'm just covering this up. You can really feel the canvas. I'm using both sides of my hands.
Ooh. So Christine says, if the gloves are too big, put two pair on. It works like a dream.
Christine, you are awesome. Thank you for your fabulous tip.
When you go to change colors, you'll have to try that.
When I go to change colors? Well, these are the only ones that I actually going to show you how you can use baby wipes.
Oh, okay, cool.
Right? To really, really, I want to make sure that there's light blending here.
Ooh, so you're going to make a...
Kind of an ombre. Dun, 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 dun. Just enjoying it. This is my canvas. Pulling it down. It's supposed to feel a little rough. Mm-hmm.
See, now you know what your brush is going through.
Right? Yeah, now you feel it. If you're ever wondering why your brushes wear out, feel this canvas.
Mm-hmm.
This is exactly what wears out brushes, is that tooth. It's kind of one of those things, it's a catch-22, the tooth, because you need it to get paint on your canvas sometimes, but it wears out your good brushes. I'm just using the tips of my fingers, and I'm just working it in the edge.
Mm-hmm.
You can see I did a whole background here. You know, have fun. If you're new to painting, if you're a little brush, your goal is to cover all the white if you can. Don't make it a stressful goal. Make it a happy goal. This should be very therapeutic. I think some of us need to be just like, I'm finger painting. Now, I could get new gloves, or I can just wet wipey these off.
Oh. What they do, they just wipe you right up.
Right? So you're not constantly changing gloves. So it's just up to you how you choose to do it. What do you have more of around the house? Wet wipes?
Mm-hmm.
Or gloves? I have kids. They're not in diapers anymore, but I just still have wet wipes around because at some point as a mom, you figure out these things clean everything.
Yes, they do. They clean the interior of leather cars really well.
So that's super fun. Let's talk about our splatter paints, right? So I've shown you these two mixes. How I'm going to thin these out, look, you could use fluid paints. Or you can add water to your heavy bodied. Remember to read the instructions. You can add about a 30% mixture of water. All of your paints should tell you how much water can thin before the paint stops binding. You could mix this with a brush. I'm just being precious, I guess, here with a palette knife. I like it because I'm trying to make sure what I'm trying to get out is chunks. Otherwise, I get lots and lots of chunks, maybe on my canvas, that I don't want.
Now, we have a really big crowd of people here today. They're all loving what you're doing here. They think this is pretty amazing. By the way, they think that they like your hair and hat. They think you look on fleek today.
So. Well, thank you very much. It's not as much a fashion choice as I felt like I could get paint all over this hat since it's my blacklight hat. And the hair is sort of in braids because I was like, then if I get clumps of paint in it, they're easier to get out. I like my braids and pigtails when I'm working sometimes.
But I wanted to
there's
remind
a lot
everybody
of us that do.
You know, don't forget to stop by. You know, we have theartsherpa.com. There it is. We put it on the screen for you. Here it is, theartsherpa.com. You can find all of our
forums.
See,
I'm just missing in here about 30% water. See that?
Oh, good.
Sorry. And I'm going to take this down here, and I've got some white. Now, what's interesting is I will probably have white left over in my splatter, and so I'll be able to get my light green mixture pretty easily here. Just stirring it. Again, you could do a brush. You can do fluid paints. If you've been paint pouring, you're like, oh my gosh, why do you need to do fluid? I didn't want people to have to feel like they had to go out and buy all other paints. You know what I mean? To constantly be finishing projects. Not that I don't think you shouldn't have a set of fluids.
Now, you like this one to be much more liquid.
Yeah, we want this one to be liquid. I'm going to add some more white over here. So again, the issue when you're thinning your paint is that you just want to make sure.
You have to stir. Put it more underneath the palette so we can see you stir.
Yeah, see, I'm really working my palette knife here. Now, the next thing I'm going to do, I'm going to do an interesting thing.
What are you going to do?
I'm going to come over here. I'm going to get this green on my palette knife.
The green goes in.
Because I want a very soft, kind of off-white green. So I used my yellow green. See that one there? So my splatters, if I were doing a Coomer painting, this is a very similar thing I would want to start out with on my splatters. Ha! So I'm ready to splatter. And we have two layers of splatters.
Do we?
Two layers of splatters between finger paints. I'm going to pull out very economical brushes.
Yes.
So I have this big, these come in big packs. They're super economical. I think they're like, I don't even want to speculate, but really, really economical.
Yep. That's their deal.
And so, you want this because you're going to be whacking these. And you're not going to be worried if, see the bristles are going to come out and stuff like that. But you're not going to worry about that because you're whacking.
Right.
So the first color I'm going to whack is my darkest color. So you see, like, I go here and I'm loading up my brush. Look at that load. All right. I'm going to come here. Whack, 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 whack. I'm going to rinse out. I'm going to give another little color whack. And I think I'll do my bright green.
Okay.
We're having fun today. Today, I am letting go. All right. So we have some big splatters with our wax. Now we're going to get our toothbrush out. Anybody have a toothbrush?
Yes. Everyone should have.
Everybody should have a toothbrush.
So you should have a couple of used ones laying around.
So I've got this nice toothbrush that I've dipped into my paint, right? See it all dipped and coated?
Oh, I do now. Hold on. Ooh.
And I'm using it to splatter my paint.
Oh, you're just getting some splatters all in there.
Yeah. These aren't like our star splatters. They're stringier. Where did my air dryer go, John?
I don't know.
Did I use it to dry my hair today? Rinse your brush out real well.
Stunt Hands is going to be running sneaker net today.
I'm thinking possibly because, well, I think actually I may be able to still go.
Okay.
Let's see how it goes. So I've got this here. I've got my wipes ready to go. I'm going to take a little of my phthalo green. Maybe I'll let a little yellow get into it.
If you need to, I don't mind grabbing it real quick.
That would be awesome, but I'm going to just see what it's doing. Oh, that's sort of nice. And I'm just going up. I'm going to let the splatters that are here become part of the painting. Look at this. I put my finger and I stroke up. This is just my brush. This is just my canvas. Maybe some dark green. Isn't that interesting how it picks up the...
It really is.
And we'll do it on the next splatter before we put... We'll do it on the when we're doing the little flowers.
You want?
I'm going to do some stem kind of strokes. So see, I'm using the tip of my finger.
Yep.
And I'm just being expressive. Be expressive. The thing to do with this style of painting... Right. I'm going to add some more yellow and maybe some white. Oh, I like that run of color. The thing to do is to not let your colors get muddy. And so that'll become a big deal when we get into the flowers because we want those to be very bright. So see, we're really mixing harmonies here. We've got the yellow and the green and the blue and the white.
Oh, yeah.
So they're not going to get muddy.
And you're really letting it mix on the board.
Oh, I'm letting it mix on board.
On the canvas there.
Yeah, you can actually precision paint with your fingers, by the way.
Well, I'm sure, yeah.
I like this expressiveness of it, but you can. See, I'm just... One thing I'm not doing is I'm not like... See, that goes... That makes everything that's interesting about the painting go away right there, doesn't it?
Oh, yeah.
I don't want that. I want the painting to feel very interesting. So I'm going to let it... Let the paint create the space that I'm working in. In the world that I'm working from. And so I've got my splatters, which are energetic and expressive. You want everything that you don't want in a star splatter, you really can enjoy here. Put out a little more green. A little more green. Fun stuff.
We have a cricket that's gotten away from us
we
here.
We do. So I hear the cricket.
You hear my cricket?
I do. Everybody so hears you're not going crazy at home. There's a cricket.
There's a cricket.
There's a cricket.
We have
I'm really using out my paint, though. It's not getting wasted.
Yeah.
And when I have an area where I feel like, oh, this was really good. This is really expressive. I really like this. I'm going to baby wipe my finger, and John's going to get my hair dry.
Your hair dry. I'll do that and let you talk to everybody.
So in this stage, when you're doing any of these kind of Coomer or Scott-style paintings, what you want to think about is that the same color mixing stuff that happens on your brush will happen in the finger paintings, right? So if you go over the green with your reds, what's that going to do to your beautiful reds? It's going to gray them out. What's that going to do to your beautiful bright colors? It could gray them out because they may be contrasting colors, opposite ends of the color wheel, and not friends like harmonies. Complementary colors. What is up with me today? Complementary colors is the correct term. Opposite ends of the color wheel. Yellow, you're so beautiful, says purple. That's a terrible joke. So, working my baby wipe to clean my glove for the same reason. Just making sure that I'm not going to be getting colors into my paint that I don't mean to. I'll probably put out some more yellow. You can plug me in. Woo! Put out some more yellow in a minute. I bet I have green and yellow freckles. I'm going to hair dry. This is good, too, if you're painting with little brushes at home. This will help them really succeed at this project. So it works for you and it works for them.
All right, guys. Now I made it back here. Thank you for coming and hanging out. Oh, my gosh. We have over 400 people here already. And there's over 200 and something likes here. But guys, thank you so much for coming and saying hello and hanging out with us today. You know, we always love having you guys out here with us. It, like, totally makes for what we do, like, fun and enjoyable coming out here and doing this live and celebrating painting and doing all of this crazy stuff with you guys. So thank you for coming and hanging out. Don't forget, like I was saying earlier, theartsherpa.com, where we have all of our traceables. They're not so much traceables on this one, I don't think, but you'll find the information about this video. We have links to all of the reference stuff for it, the materials list, and of course you can find all the chat and the forums and More information on the big art quest, which is also out there. You know, I think it's up there as well. So you can go to /BAQ. You can find the shop and all that kind of fun stuff out there. But of course, please come and share your pictures so we can see those and we can, I'd love to see all the work that you guys do and have a chance to look at that. So, you know, thank you guys. I'm going to go over here and I'll find some music so that when Cinnamon's coming back in here, hopefully we can, have her come in. And we can just let her know that we are definitely at that place where she should be wiggling her fingers and wiggling her toes, right? Because we have way over Sherpa in our room, Cinnamon. We have over 400 people with us. We're having a good time. Again, thank you guys for coming and hanging out. Love seeing you with us. And of course, today, we're going to let our fingers get a little more exercise with Cinnamon. Doing our painting today.
I'm sorry.
You just gotta go that one more play. You just gotta take it up one more notch every day. You're just upping it.
What's my notch?
I don't know. I'm just.
What's my notch?
You have notches.
Can I point out that I really love this turquoise that we made earlier?
Yeah.
I just. Really
I don't know. No, you cannot.
So I'm gonna
point
really,
it out.
Really. Because I didn't double glove. But you know what? Should I try her tip and
sure.
double glove?
Why not?
I'm going to try your tip.
We're finger dancing while we're waiting Ooh. For you. Where are you? I can't, we can't see. You didn't share the...
Oh, I got two gloves on there?
She said. That's what she said.
You smart.
So she,
You're
no.
smart community member. Thank you.
I think it was Christy. I think it was Christy.
Oh, and I really... Was it?
Yep.
Hey, sweetie, I love it.
She's a new member, I believe. I had...
So I'm going to pull out some of my white paint. I'm going to get a little of my quinacridone here. Load up my finger. Like this. It's fun stuff. And right here, I think I'm going to make a little flower. And I like to just sort of make this little general. I did little cone flowers were my inspiration.
Yeah.
So that's sort of where that came from for me. That's what was giving me love. And, you know, I wanted to paint something that was good for Mother's Day, was super happy, good for spring. So I'm just, you can see I'm just loading up here. Look at me now.
You loaded your finger up.
And now you can see why I dried the green, because it's not just coming through on my pink. Right? That would have messed me up, man. Ruined my whole jam. You can see I'm doing these bigger on the bottom. Kind of swirl them around, but I leave the swirlies in, don't I?
You do. I want to get zoomed in on your swirliness.
Look at that. I could come over and grab some yellow as a surprise into the mixture. And maybe right here, make this. Oh, I love this, like sherbet. This is, every once in a while, there's this clothing place called Gymboree.
Mm-hmm.
And they make these kids' clothes, and they have these little different stories for spring and summer. And I love the spring stories because they go into these colors. Not everyone. When they do, I get so excited and go shopping.
Shopping.
Shopping. I'm going to pull some more paint. More yellow. Just work this out. This one is going to be yellow. So you can see that I am thinking about my design, aren't I? I am trying to create balance. I'm going to arc this fan out. I'm going to really enjoy that. Oh, doesn't that look like candy?
Yeah.
It does, it does. Let's get some more white. Oh, got some blue in it. But I'm not going to worry about it. I'm going to go right here and just make a little flower. Maybe another little one right there.
A lot of folks are really enjoying this thing. This is a very de-stressing activity.
It really is. I could do about 20 of these in a day and have an art show about 2 seconds later.
You clean
it would just
there.
Be like, and be like, I painted with my, I totally get where Messiah Scott is coming from because doing this is so relaxing, man.
Yeah.
I'm going to take my yellow over to my red. Now, if I were doing this for a professional painting, I probably would have made the decision to use Peril Red here. It's a naphthol. Because it's such an intense and powerful red.
Mm-hmm.
And that there. But, you know. Got some of that. What happens if I go like that? Got a lot of white on my finger. It's so interesting to see what happens as the pigment goes, right? That one's a little bit bigger. Grab a little red here.
Ooh, where'd you go?
in a little yellow. Kind of mixed it a bit.
A bit.
Because I want more of a fire poker. Oh, look at that.
Oh, I like it.
Yeah, I do too. I'm really having fun. I can't lie to you. I could. Well, I don't know why I would. Would seem very strange to do. I'm going to mislead you.
This is
about
not fun.
Finger painting.
Don't. It's not fun at all. We're just enjoying ourselves immensely. So
that happened. Yeah. I'm going to put out a little more white.
White?
Because this white is getting a little contaminated. And I'm not saying that it isn't useful for the painting, but I'm trying to do some very specific things here. So I'm going to leave a little clean white out here and there. So I'm going to grab a little of my purple, let it hit my blue a bit, come and grab a little white.
Ooh, there it goes.
I might have a little magenta in purple here. Get a little white.
I like that purpley.
Do you?
Yeah.
I do too. Just painting this little guy right there. Maybe there's a little friend, but he's like not as resolved.
Just implied.
You know, just because we're painting with our fingers doesn't mean we're not really painting. Right?
Mm.
I think that's an interesting thing. I thought it was real funny that there was an instant sort of reaction on this video when it was suggested. And I think that's because, you know, sometimes we don't feel like messes are fun. But they can be fun. But messes can be very artful and intentional. And we can enjoy them.
Yeah.
I'm going to get that word color because I just think it'll be interesting. So see, ooh, that was a little more rainbow.
Whoa, I was going to say, that's a rainbow. That was like a little unicorn flower.
Let me grab another one and see if we can do it again.
Where are you going to go?
Ready? Hold on, how do we think it's going to go? We're experimenting.
I'm going to see where you... Okay.
Let's see. How I'm getting this to not be a gray, icky mess.
Oh, wow.
Is I'm not overmixing. I'm letting it.
That's really
I'm
cool.
Allowing it to be...
So,
what it is.
Where are you going to go? Hold on. Let me get
right here?
In. Let me get.
Should we put one here or here? Here?
Okay, wherever you want to go.
Like this little batch, maybe they got pollinated by a very confused bee.
I'm very zoomed in, so the camera moves fast.
So I think that's as far as I'm going to get those, but you can see I didn't waste that paint, right? And I'm going to come and grab some of my magenta aggressively. A little blue, a little purple, some white. And I'll continue on with my purple story. My magentas. Look at that. Enjoyable story.
Mm-hmm.
Let's get a dark one here. Let's go dark horse right here. This one's so dark.
So dark. I like that.
Has some values. So see, we've done values here. Let me use my wet wipe. And now I'm going to finish with a toothbrush splatter.
Okay.
This is what softens the piece and gives it kind of like a mellow resolution.
Ooh.
So I've got this paint loaded on my brush.
I was over looking at the painting.
And I'm going to just flick. And this is a little bit more like when we do galaxy stars, this flick. Can you see how it's similar?
Yeah, no, where did you get, I didn't see where you got that paint from.
Okay. So this is that cup.
Oh.
This is a lot of yellow, a little titch of white, a little titch of green, and some white.
Okay.
But not the soft mint that we made earlier. Right?
So you kind of rub it in there a little bit?
Yeah, we just want this bright green. And I do tend to rub in. And see, when I flick this way, I get one flick. And then when I flick to the side, I get another flick. So it's fun to see how the different flicking of your brush impacts your result. Maybe let it go up here a little bit so that there's some blending. There's some softening, isn't there? Like
some
pixels
layers.
Softening this image. So this is how we're getting a bokeh in our finger paint.
Oh.
Now I got to wipe this off.
Clean.
Clean, clean, clean. And I'll rinse this guy out.
This is really nice.
It's fun, right?
Yeah.
There's fun happening here. All right, let's get another fun color. This is that soft mint we made together.
Oh, yeah.
Right? Now, if you've got the budget, you can just do fluid paints. Boy, you can just make this stuff real easy and cup it up. And they have cups with lids, so you can even save this. You're not even wasting money.
Mm-hmm.
You're just going from project to project. I have a bunch of cups with lids for paint pouring. And I find that's really letting me enjoy my pours and save my extras for little adventures on another day.
And what's really great is that it's okay if it gets big splatters, because this is just sort of...
It's supposed to.
It's abstract.
It's okay if it drips. It's okay if it gets big splatters. It's abstracted. It's expressive.
Is this actually abstract impressionism?
It's pretty darn close. I think probably we're now into a new movement because of the artist currently working in this.
Mm.
Which I don't offhand know what it's called, but yes. It somewhere certainly owes its roots to that thinking.
We walked through that camp on the way here.
We walked through that camp hardcore on the way here. So I'm going to just add a little bit of white to the splatter just for some pop.
Some layers.
There we go. Now, even though we've finger painted, we've also simultaneously really arted.
We arted, dude.
We arted. I'm going to take off my gloves. And I'm going to use the only brush of the day.
The only brush?
The only brush of the day, because I've got to do your favorite part.
Will you sign it?
I'm going to sign it. Maybe I'm going to sign it over here in the mint.
Did you put your fingerprint in there?
Well, that would be cheeky and a decent artist statement. But I'll just take this mint that I have aside and this nice number two round. A beautiful monogram I gotta go locate that's like insane for this. My serious signing brush.
Serious signing brush. That looks pretty good to me though.
Yeah, I think so.
Got the Sherpa on the canvas. We were pretty quick today.
I think it was a fun day. I hope you guys enjoyed your finger paint. That actually all stayed in. That was like a magic trick. Why don't I ever catch this stuff on camera? So, yeah, gravity. Interesting suction. So, science. It was beautiful spending this time with you today. I hope you had fun. I hope you guys will experiment with this idea a little bit and make tons and tons of florals with your fingers. Check out the iCard or the information below for some more fun stuff if you find this is your jam. Be good to yourselves. Be good to each other. Stay as open-hearted as you can. And I want to see you at the easel really, really soon. Bye-bye.